네.
As mentioned by Dr. Min, this is the last session. That's why we will continue without break with the panel discussion. One thing I'd like to ask for your understanding. As mentioned, K Shipbuilding, that's the company which was previously known as SDX Shipbuilding, and disclosing information, especially in the case of private business, is quite difficult. And he was asked to come back to the company. He had some urgent matters to attend to. That is why Mr. Lim cannot join us for this panel discussion. Instead, we invited Dr. Lee of Research Institute of Medium and Small Shipbuilding, LIMS. He is in charge of various R&D projects for small and medium-sized shipbuilders. And as in the case of last year, today we are joined by Mr. Shin Hong-woo of Creative Purse. And Mr. Shin is very active in various associations and groups. And he is also working as a member of the Technology Evaluation Committee. Before Lim left, I shared a question from the floor, and I received his answer. So my question is, in a large scale vessel, cybersecurity is very important. And in designing a vessel, what are the greatest threats when it comes to the cybersecurity? And what are the values and the effects of risk management? And he mentioned that cybersecurity, the concept of cybersecurity and the threats, can be better understood when we look back on what happened in our society when the Kakao data center caught fire and our entire lives were suspended all of a sudden. And if a large scale vessel, if they cannot operate for any reason, for especially cyber attack, then that will deal a serious blow to our daily lives. That is why it is quite important to ensure the proper cybersecurity related measures. Shipbuilders and shippers, ship owners, as well as the parts and component manufacturers should fully understand the importance of cybersecurity. And this should be taken into consideration not only in building and designing a vessel, but also in operating a vessel. So that was the message from Mr. Lim before he left. So one of the questions we prepared, I shared with Mr. Lim. Now I'd like to turn to Mr. Lim. So I'd like to know what is the area you believe we should focus on in promoting the collaboration. I am Im Hak-su of Kiosk in advanced shipbuilding and maritime industry with the development in the ICT. The industry is undergoing quite a high pace of digitalization, and based on the shipbuilding and maritime data, and I think, well, this is the area we have to focus more in relation to the digital reverse engineering, 3D modeling, AR, VR, virtualization, digital twin platform, as well as AI generative design. I believe that in that respect, what's the most important thing is the collaborative project among and between industry, academia, and research institutes. the local support and government R&D projects are very important and indispensable, but especially in the industrial field, in relation to the technological development as well as safety, we should be able to nurture resources, and we have to further promote collaboration between and among academia, research institute, and industry. Thank you.
So, thank you very much. And we had very good discussions previously as well. So maybe we can visit his organization soon in order to explore further opportunities for cooperation with our agency. I would like to ask a question to Mr. Lee Han-seong, Director of the Research Institute of Medium and Small Shipbuilding. Last year, we had the session on medium and small shipbuilding. And this year, we also do the project together for medium and small shipbuilding. Because of the unique environment of the shipbuilding industry, as well as the safety issues, I believe the very strict regulations are applied. And I'm sure that you do have your unique special requirement. And this discussion session is sponsored by the Ministry of Oceans. And also, we have a expo-related event, which is, again, under different ministry. So in that sense, I believe cooperation is critical between different agencies and also with the Busan City and many relevant organizations. So here you see we have central government bodies, local government bodies, as well as the academic institutes and so on. So how can we ensure smooth cooperation, and what kind of roles each stakeholder should play? Yes, so I am Lee Han-seong from the Research Institute of the Medium and Small Shipbuilding. And because the Mr. Yi from the K Shipbuilding left, so I think I am the only person who represents the industry in the panel. For the shipbuilding industry, yes, we have issues like the industrial safety, design, and so on. In the past, these topics were not really brought to the surface for the discussion. Why? Because one of the key characteristics of the shipbuilding industry is that it's based on the optimized engineering plan in order to produce the marine platform or ships at the lowest possible cost. So cost saving was always the priority, and therefore the safety issues and design issues were somehow put on the back burner. So we didn't really prioritize the safety issues before. We talked about the on-site safety, but safety technology is pretty new concept. With the emergence of digital transformation. But before that, I don't think that we put a lot of focus on these issues. So for shipbuilders, the design, if they try to implement the design elements, then this will bring up, drive up the cost. So this is something that industry is reluctant to take, but then with the digital transformation, and also with the emergence of approach to build human-centered environment, safety technologies become prioritized. And in Korea, actually, we are lagging behind in terms of the institution and policies that promote safety. I believe the leader or the country with the greatest institutions are those in Northern Europe. So they have a very, very strong foundation regulations to promote safety in shipbuilding technologies, and they have been a leader for safety-related technology development. And recently, only recently, Korea started to recognize the importance of this issue. And against this backdrop, the Ministry of Oceans and also other relevant ministries, they, I think, are trying to establish some policies and foundations And for this, they have conducted some R&D projects. But that started only 1 to 2 years ago. So I believe the government should continuously provide support for R&D projects. And at the same time, they should monitor and establish a surveillance system for industries and business players and local government, especially focusing on the city of Busan. You see that the business environment has a lot of areas for improvement. So the hydrological environment, compared to large shipyards, Busan players are suffering from poor environment. So in this sense, I think we have to get some support from local government. And also these players are suffering from various economic disadvantages as well. So when introducing safety technology, sometimes it can actually pose a direct threat to the very existence of this business because they cannot afford the cost for safety technology. And this, therefore, shows that they need some financial support or policy support from the local government. And for academic sector, they should engage in R&D activities for safety standards and establish relevant policies. And also they have to foster talent who can tap in these safety technologies. So generally in shipbuilding sector, we have to have talent. We are short of talents who can utilize and lead the development of safety technology. And therefore, the universities should develop a training program. And also the industries and business players, they have to realize that shipbuilding is a labor-intensive industry. And they try to turn a blind eye to safety accident. That's just sort of the tendency. But I believe that the business players should be mature enough to put priority on this issue, accept and embrace government monitoring and surveillance, and also proactively develop the relevant technology. Otherwise, I think the shipbuilding industry could suffer a lot from safety issues. So thank you very much for the great answer. Since I work for the Design Promotion Institute, so I'd like to make the suggestion that up until today, we only pursued the price competitiveness, and we tried to minimize the cost as much as possible while trying to enhance the performance. So that was the process that most shipbuilders have taken so far. But in the coming future, in order to gear up ourselves for the coming future, I believe that we really have to target premium customers, a premium client who have some special demand. And therefore, we have to pursue both price competitiveness, and also we have to target some niche market with special demand, and we have to be prepared for this. And in doing so, our institute can help the business players who mainly focus on hardware sectors. But with our soft skills, maybe we can also have some meaningful cooperation with them. Any other comments from other panelists?
Please feel free to jump in. I thought that I should give each and every one at least an opportunity to add on to what they have said. And I found the presentation by Mr. Min Jung-tuk quite interesting. He is from the Korean Institute of Robotics and Technology Convergence. The presentation was very easy to understand very intuitive. And as you have designed various projects in terms of the efficacy or effectiveness, I'd like to know, though you are focusing on technology, is there any experience? Do you have any experience when it comes to the power of design or benefits of design? And if you have any such experience, please share with us today. As I mentioned in my presentation, it's only the second year of the project, and I don't think it's time for me. It's a bit too early to give you any kind of feedback. But there are three main pillars of the project. And the first one is shipbuilding. About the guard and the design, I think encompasses design of the vessel as well, of a vessel as well. So I think what's the key here is to incorporate the feedback. We are working with RIMS, and we've witnessed RIMS working with in Design Council Busan. We clearly saw the design need or the request for the design implementation, and the result was quite satisfactory. So I think, well, we should start from what customers want. I have been developing robots quite a lot, quite expensively over the last 10 years. We have developed 80 different types of robots, and some of them have been commercialized. Since we are focusing on the performance and the functions, we do not focus that much on aesthetics. As for for example, underwater robots, well, their functions are way more important than their design, how they look like. And as for the hull cleaning robot, their performance and their functioning is way more important than design. But we were wrong when we designed the cleaning robot, hold a cleaning robot. But if we are talking about a pool, they also use a cleaning robot. But there is such a high, not really high, but they have higher design requirement as compared to hull cleaning robot. But designer focusing on aesthetics, what they want is not exactly aligned with the function designer. So I think what we need is a designer with an engineering background and with an in-depth understanding of the marine environment. When we develop a robot for agricultural industry, then you should have an in-depth understanding of the agricultural industry. So if you are to develop underwater robot, then you should have the clear understanding as to the underwater environment. But to locate such a talent is not that easy. So I think rather than asking designers, the engineers, rather than engineers to incorporate design aspects, I think, well, that we should look for designers with engineering background. And toward the end of my project, we should be able to give you quite a detailed and concrete feedback. I think, well, you made a very clear point. McKinsey of the United States, as they promoted the concept of next new normal, and they highlighted that designers should have an engineering background and capability, and engineers should have a designer capability, because the line has already been blurred. And designers without understanding of the engineering, they cannot go any further. So I think your comment was really insightful. Thank you. And as for ship design, I believe Creative Purse is the only company which is specialized in ship design in Busan. In the past, there were many companies who did ship design, and I think Creative Purse is the most active one in this field. And now I'd like to turn to Mr. Shin Hyung-woo.
So the design, because of the marine environment characteristics and also the other priorities, and we need some special expertise for the maritime safety management. And this has somehow raised the barrier for entry. And in order to break down these barriers, what approaches we should take, or what kind of advice will you give?
Yes, so I am Shin Hyung from Creative Force. So what I am going to cover, I think is somehow related with the initial part of our discussion. So I think the keyword for the design, this is something that I talked about before. And design is not just about like selecting color pattern or selecting a beautiful shape. Rather, design is about the design elements, colors, patterns, as well as the services that customers want. So it's a very broad, comprehensive term that embraces various elements. And therefore, when implementing marine design, the challenges that we have to fulfill is that we have to make sure that the ships have to survive in a hostile environment. So this requires a strong expertise in the understanding of marine environment, as well as in the structure of ships, from the generator to the instruments. So all the parts and components of the ships should be thoroughly understood to come up with the right design. And for this, we have to have the education or training centers to train people with these broad topics. And then the talents who are educated there will become the leaders of marine design. So I think this is something that we have to work on. Thank you very much. So yes, the human resources, they are truly an important asset. And I completely agree with what you said. Moving on.
And Dr. Lim, although you made a comment, although we have RIMS in the shipbuilding industry, the safety-related design, and in order to facilitate the development of such a design or safety-related technology, the central government support for consistent and continuous sustainable policy support is indispensable. Since you are at the KIMS, if you have any take on this, please share with us. Mosie, designated Busan as an ICT hub for the maritime industry. And currently, a National Maritime Cluster R&D is underway for Busan. And Busan-based cluster projects is about maritime safety and design as well on the way. And the Ministry of Land and Transport has a plan to adopt the smart technologies in design, encompassing construction, maintenance, as well as monitoring. And I believe the government has a plan to make a huge investment in this regard. And the Ministry of Oceans and Fisheries are also making a significant investment in the North Port development. And the Marine City and Underwater City are also part of the government plan. Since Busan is a marine city, it is exposed to natural disasters, and it is quite important to build a disaster-proof city. That is why smart design and digital twin technologies are indispensable. Although the current administration has been reducing the government R&D project quite significantly, but I believe that smart design technology will help Busan to go farther in advanced technologies, and I believe that KIMST, my institute, can play a role in attracting government budget for the development of marine and maritime technology. And since Busan is well positioned to benefit from those technologies. And next month, it will be finalized whether Busan will successfully host the World Expo 2030. And once Busan is selected, then Busan will enjoy a bountiful opportunity to further develop satellite, bio, as well as other design applications and related technologies. Thank you. Thank you for your great answer. I totally agree. Since you are in charge of the R&D project at KIMST, if there is any opportunity for you to work with Design Council of Busan, that will be very much appreciated. Thank you.
Anyone from the floor? Do you have any questions to our panelists? So if you do have any questions or comments, please raise your hand and we'll give you the microphone. I have been serving as moderator for various forums and also participant, and somehow I think time management is just to the dot perfect. So while thinking about the question, I will make some additional comment that the Mr. Park Ho-sang from the Korea Maritime Transportation Safety Authority, and his presentation was about the various safety accidents. So this is to set the stage for our session and panel discussion today. And so because it was only for like setting the stage, so I didn't really have particular questions. That's why I didn't ask the questions to him. But anyone from the floor, do you have questions to Mr. Park?
Oh, yeah.
So good afternoon. I am from the Busan Design Promotion Institute. My name is Hong Yo-sun. And I really enjoyed all the presentation. So whether it's the ICT or the robots, so I think these new technologies have been the focus of our discussion. And for the marine and shipbuilding, my personal impression is that they are very unique. In particular, the architectures are built on the sea, in the sea, and on the surface of the sea. So in architecture, the safety design has been incorporated in order to beef up the safety. So for ships or shipbuilding, let's say with the simple modification of the design. For example, like because it's on the surface of the sea, maybe we can employ some design concept to prevent the falling accident into the sea. So do you have any examples where a simple modification of the design has led to the significant safety enhancement? Thank you. So he's from the Design Council of Busan. And our panelists, I don't think that they're actually in the right position to answer that question, but so I will rather answer the question.
that recently when we pursue new project, yes, we suggest like on-demand intelligence-based platform, and we recently initiated the relevant project. So this indicates that even for design, the basis should be the technology. That's what government pursues now, and therefore we have to pay attention to generative AI and also various ICT technologies and incorporate that into design projects. So rather than targeting large vessels, maybe we can target UI, UX approaches. And so in this sense, I think Design Council Busan can play a critical role. I will also make some comment on that question. In 2019, with the amendment of the law, our organization got renamed, and our major mission is to conduct investigation for vessels and as well as manage passenger ships. And I think safety and design, they should go hand in hand. Safety has been emphasized, but somehow design has been overlooked, and we haven't really had the strong institutions or foundations for beautiful design. So we have a lot of international conventions and regulations for sea and shipbuilding, and also we have national regulations, for example, like fishing ship law and the leisure watercraft law and so on. And we have to comply with these laws for safety management. So when constructing fishing vessel, let's say, there is a clause in that law that the design that does not suit with the fishing vessel should not be applied. So this indicates that design elements are not really fully considered and reflected in Korea's legal setting. And also the older components that go into the vessels that are under the Korean regulation, they have to receive tests and fulfill the requirements for safety. So as far as I know, I think a lot of design elements are somehow ignored and dismissed. They are not really covered by the regulation in Korea. So when we embarked on the Han River Renaissance project, the Seoul city government tried to establish some floating structures. And I tried to design them together, but there was an issue with the regulation. So in other words, structures that come into contact with the water, it's under the ship safety law. And also for the substructures that goes above the sea is subject to different law by the Ministry of Construction. And so because there are a lot of restrictions and regulation in relation with the structures that go above the sea structure, so in order to take into consideration the design element, I believe that there should be some amendment of the existing regulations so that they can deal with more design elements, especially the notices and ordinances have to be amended. So this is my comment. Thank you.
Thank you for your comment. When the concept of design was introduced into Korea, it was categorized as applied art. So design has been considered to be something pleasant to see and easy to use. So color, touch, and texture, external appearance, that's not all about design. That's not the end of the design. I think, well, features should be incorporated into design as well, and the design is bigger than that. So when I say to my team members, I say that, well, you should not go too much. And design is all about doing only as much as it is needed. And I also believe that that captures the current positioning of design in the society. I think we run out of time. In 8 seconds, we are to be finished. Thank you very much for your participation. And I'd like to thank all the panelists and speakers for taking their precious time despite busy schedules and responding to the invitation of Design Council Busan. Please give them a lot of round of big hands. And with that, I would like to conclude this marine design session under the theme of shipbuilding and marine industries and safety design. Thank you for your participation. Thank you. Please give another round of big applause to our moderator. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you very much. And this concludes the marine design session, the last session of day two of the 17th World Ocean Forum. Thank you for staying with us till the last minute of this program. And we will begin at 10 a.m. in the morning. And we have prepared various sessions, including marine bio. And I'd like to ask for your continued interest and participation. Thank you.